Madam Chancellor, it is an honor and privilege to present to you for the degree of Doctor of Laws, honoris causa, the Honorable Judith Guichon.
Wow. I'm humbled. Thank you, first of all, to the elders for that warm welcome. I am so honored to be back here in the Sinaiac territory. Chancellor Mundell, Dr. Nielsen, platform guests, honored platform guests, students, parents, and families. It is truly, it's hard for me to comprehend that I think it was just this January I stood on this same stage as we congratulated graduates and honored Robert Bateman. Now I find myself the recipient of this recognition, and I am humbled. Humbled indeed to be the honorary doctorate recipient. And as I look back over my life, it is with great humility that I stand here before you. Part of that humility is caused as I consider the many ways in which our previous generations have failed in our stewardship of our shared home. Particularly as we stand here in this auditorium where tradition, nature, artistry, and culture are so cherished, I am reminded once again of the world we have bequeathed to you, our students, and the great stresses that we have put upon it. I think of the challenges you will face as you find creative ways to respond and to repair our previous errors. One accomplishment during my tenure as Lieutenant Governor, of which I am very proud, is the Stewards of the Future program. This past weekend, we just held our third annual Stewards Conference, where we brought 8 grade 10 students from around BC as far away as the cusp and up island at a remote reserve, Sabellas. We brought them together on the Sunshine Coast. The challenge was for these young people to work together to create a vision of Canada for 2067, a greener vision. Around the world, there's much chaos at the moment, and there are some who question the warnings about climate change. But evidence abounds, and your generation will be faced with finding better ways to live more in tune with the natural world. Our young stewards were from very different cultural, economic, and geographic backgrounds, but they were united in their commitment to find ways to create a greener vision for their communities and for the province by the time we reach our 200th anniversary in Canada 2067. As we celebrate our sesquicentennial, it's a great opportunity to consider our history, the path that has led us to this point, our grave errors and injustices, and our successes. All the many colorful threads that are woven into the tapestry that is the fabric of this nation. 2067 is an opportunity to celebrate the nation that we have built from sea to sea to sea, and to work at reconciliation as we learn to better understand one another and to appreciate and respect our various cultures and our diversity. It is a time to celebrate and to enjoy the positive products of our labor, which we as Canadians are so privileged to enjoy, none of which needs to diminish our resources. These positive products are time to enjoy the great beauty that surrounds us. Freedom to make choices, good or bad, and to learn from them. And opportunities for love, lust, and laughter. You graduates are now the future leaders to whom we will pass on the responsibility to guard these precious commodities. And so I urge you to take this moment in time to consider your options, set goals based on your values to guide your future choices, and then grab the opportunities that will continually present themselves with a great lust for life, with much laughter, and above all, with love. Thank you to Vancouver Island University, the Chancellor, the President, the elders, and the whole community for this tremendous honor today. And thank you for making me a part of this beautiful, diverse, and rich community, which is helping to create a positive future for us all. Thank you.